I'm tired. I am so tired. I've been working on video uploads nonstop for a while now. We're like 2 weeks away from releasing Joshua and the Promised Land Reanimated. And that has been a beast of a project to manage. Now, don't get me wrong, I am so incredibly hyped for its release. And after over a year of working on it, I couldn't be more proud or excited for its premiere, which will be later this month, by the way. That being said, it's taken a lot out of me. So I need a nice, simple video topic for this week. Something that won't stress me out. And if anything, brings me peace of mind.
Freeze! Gif mode activate!
Nope.
I'm going to die. Furry Force is a 3-episode long web series that features overly sexualized fursonas in a satirical Saturday morning cartoon setting. Yep, and let me tell you, this show is not for the faint of heart. Like, if you can't handle gross out humor, then you might want to go pick up your Bible and walk away.
Those of you with weak constitutions may want to leave the stadium.
I gotta get out of here.
Too late. Ready or not, here he comes.
Guys, I've never seen this series before. I've heard of it, but I've never seen it. I'm telling the truth. I even reacted to the episodes on my Twitch so people could get my authentic reactions. I guess I'm gonna get banned by both YouTube and Twitch at this point. I'm speedrunning my downfall, baby. I actually had to take a moment and was like, does this one go too far? Should I just skip this topic? But I couldn't help myself. I was morbidly curious, and what I discovered definitely surprised me. So, what are the origins behind Furry Force? Well, the web series was created by Adam Conover and Brian Murphy, and it flew under the banner of College Humor. Gosh, remember them? Definitely one of the old guards of YouTube, with some of their oldest videos dating back to, get this, 2006. God, I'm old. Adam and Brian have gone on to create bigger and better things, such as Adam Ruins Everything. But these guys have a humble internet background and used it as a springboard into the mainstream spotlight. Actually, I was a bit concerned that these two would end up being out-of-touch bullies when it comes to furries. But guess what? It was kind of the opposite. The first episode was released in January of 2014 and has, at this moment, almost 12 million views. According to an interview from Vulture, quote, Murphy and Conover were relieved that the furry community found the first episode funny and not offensive. They had peace of mind while making the sequel, knowing that the furry community was on board and didn't take themselves too seriously. Hell, Adam even did an AMA on a furry subreddit like 7 years ago and said the following. The idea was originally pitched by Murph. We then later wrote the script together. I think it came from a few things. One, the feeling that a lot of furry culture comes from 90s Saturday morning kids cartoons. So, what if there was a real Saturday morning cartoon about modern furry culture? It's just a funny idea that, if there were furry superheroes, their power would be that the villains wouldn't be able to deal with them. We just love the details of furry culture. It's a very rich, funny world. It's super fun to do the voice of an evil supervillain getting mildly gross out. End quote. Adam also mentioned how he's known the furry community since he grew up in the anime fandom, and both respective fandoms would rub shoulders with one another through osmosis. Not like that. Or maybe like that, who knows? Murphy is also on record saying, quote, I don't have a mean-spirited sense of humor. So when everyone gets the joke and everyone is on it together, that certainly makes me respect the community a lot more for just having fun with it. So all in all, it sounds like both Adam and Brian came from a genuine place with Furry Force and intended to have fun with it. Though I can understand if there are those who don't feel the same way. Though I gotta say, it's pretty awesome that Furry Force got nominated for this furry award called the Ursa Major and actually won. They even made a video to gain support. According to an interview, Adam said, quote, what better honor is there for comedy writers than for the community that you are making fun of to give you an award for how much they love what you made? End quote. All in all, I see this as a satisfying conclusion for something that could have been potentially spiteful and cruel. Adam and Brian rolled with the punches, and it seems that a good portion of the furry fandom has a great sense of humor. I mean, I feel it's kind of required, and you should just double down on it. I saw a picture not too long ago that had this bunch of furries on an airplane flying back from a furry con, and how the flight attendants were like, "What the hell is this, lol? Ah, screw it. Let's take some pictures together." I gotta say, that's really cool. A good sense of humor can make things so much better. But someone on Twitter made an appropriate observation. They said that if the plane crashes, it would basically cripple the American IT industry in an instant. Yeah, I think they're right.
You're out of here.
Hi.
So, what is Furry Force about? Fortunately for you all, it's short. There are only like 3 episodes plus a bonus video. Unfortunately for you all, I recorded my reactions to it on Twitch. By the way, go follow me on Twitch. So, instead of me explaining each episode in excruciating detail, which would, by the way, be very difficult to do with Pastor YouTube over my shoulder, instead, you're going to see my genuine reactions to the episodes. You've been warned.
This is for research purposes, all right? Here we go, episode 1. Am I about to get in trouble? Am I about to get trouble? Here we go. How far are we in the video? 30 seconds? 30 seconds in a 2.5 minute long video, and I'm already... Okay.
Furry forces on the prowl! Police
power must! Oh, smells like wet fur and sex!
I'm having second thoughts. I don't know. I feel like I'm gonna... I don't know. If the point of the shirt was to make you uncomfortable, then mission accomplished.
Prepare to die, perverts.
Furries, perverts. Gift mode activate.
Gift mode, uh-oh. Like a Voltron or some... Why didn't anybody warn me? Why did none of you tell me to stop? Alright, I guess they're doing this.
Now back to Furry Force on Fox Kids!
That's a house.
Furry Force!
Persona Transformation!
No! Wait for me to hang up first!
Oh, God! Is the Squirrel One pregnant? What the fuck?
It's time to get pounded by the Furry Force!
Strong!
He's just doing what it out.
Where I, Victor Viva. Well, oh, stop that. Stop biting. Ew. Hip hop, restrain them.
I'm sorry. The villain's the best character. He's the best character.
It's okay, Mr. President. We'll get you out of here.
I'm sorry. I can't be seen talking to you.
I have to be real with you guys. The writing's pretty funny.
You know what to do.
You got it.
No. No, 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 please, I can't. I can't. No, they don't show it. I'm scrubbing through the timeline. Alright, guys, I'm sorry. Let's just rip this band-aid off.
Oh, no! I can't move! I can't look away!
This isn't happening, this isn't happening, this isn't happening!
Kill me! I can't kill me!
Back to Furry Force on Fox Kids.
Finally, I will stop the Furry Force once and for all. Behold, my newest creation.
It looks a bit different with the animation.
Scaly Squad.
The Scaly Squad.
The dragon won't stop rubbing.
Oh.
Everyone on Earth has transformed.
Oh, that dog is so stacked. Please tell me I died first. Oh shit, there I am.
90% of the population was wiped out by a milky tidal wave.
Oh, God, that's totally jizz, isn't it?
You know, knowing 2020 and 2021, I wouldn't put this out of the cards for something that could happen.
I welcome death.
All right, well, I don't know why I think episode 1 was the hardest to watch. But maybe it's because we had to rip the band-aid off. Well, yeah, okay. Wow. Wow, indeed, right?
So, what are my overall thoughts about Furry Force? Well, I think it's disgusting. It's graphic. It's freaking funny! Like, seriously, what a genuine surprise! I expected to hate this series and thought it would be stupid, low-hanging jokes that aren't even clever. But that, in my opinion, was not really the case. Now, don't get me wrong. The humor is very crass and is hypersexualized, but in a way where it's obviously so. And the reactions from the villain just kill me.
Stop that. Stop writing. Ew.
I also like the angle of this being a Saturday morning cartoon, something that is very universal to many of us, and the tropes that follow it. A bunch of heroes assembling to fight the villain of the week and transforming into robots or superheroes or something. But here, it's a bit different. It is fursonas, like Thundercats, but rated MA. The designs of the characters are obviously goofing on fursona designs that skew to the, how can I put it, creative and lewd side of the fandom. I actually like how the folks who made this show said that they did their research on DeviantArt for, you know, inspiration. That's hilarious to me. So yeah, lots of sexual preferences and terminology in here. Stuff that isn't typically on the radar of mainstream culture. And that is the point. It's a shock, and it's uncomfortable. It's supposed to be uncomfortable. A bunch of henchmen just backing away slowly from heroes because they don't even want to touch them. Also, the animation was fine. Nothing outstanding, but well-made and competent enough for an online web series. But let me tell you, that final moment in episode 3, the tidal wave of, you know, yeah, that was the line in the sand for me. And that wave absolutely crashed into it. The beach was never seen again, nor the line in the sand. For those who do watch this, I hope that you all have a high tolerance for this kind of stuff. Because if not, then this web series is not for you.
Oh, thank God!
Master! No! Take me with you!
So, in conclusion, Furry Force was, needless to say, an experience. That first episode was quite the doozy, and very much so a shocker, but I cannot deny that it was funny. Like, I was expecting this thing to be wholeheartedly dumb and condescending, and above all else, spiteful. Just dunking on furries cause, furries are weird, right? Well, yeah, they are. There's no defending that. And if anything, it helps to be able to laugh at yourself and your community. Now, that is completely my own personal opinion. And I'm certain that many people won't feel the same and are probably exhausted with how often their fandom gets dragged through the mud. However, Furry Force has a certain level of nuance with its writing, where it's almost winking at furries who have to deal with reactions from people like the villain. I've seen fursuiters at conventions, specifically in elevators, standing shoulder to shoulder with businessmen. Businessmen who have no idea what's going on. And let me tell you, the look in their eyes, priceless. How could you not find that situation amusing? So yeah, Furry Force definitely surprised me. Once more, it's a lot in both its writing and visuals and jokes and overall presentation, but in a way where it doubles down on its own satire and is so outrageous that believing every furry behaves this way is kind of ridiculous. Props to those in the furry community for being able to laugh at itself and even giving Furry Force an award. That was probably the best way you could have reacted to this series. Outside, of course, of pausing the video and finding your nearest confessional booth. Now, if you will excuse me, I need to go find the nearest confessional booth.